Hey there, folks. Dave Altavilla for HotHardware.com here with the bodaciously big and beautiful, we would say, Samsung Infuse 4G. This is a new 4G capable phone for the AT&T network by Samsung, and it sports a 4.5-inch Super AMOLED display that is absolutely gorgeous. As you can see, really nice viewing angles here, really good brightness, color, contrast, and the deep, deep blacks that are associated with Super AMOLED display technology. So just really nice display and screen real estate here available to power users for a smartphone. Again, a large, large device. It's still pocketable. You're gonna know what's in your pocket though. It's a thin device, however, about 9 millimeters thick, and it's lightweight, we would say. Definitely lighter than some of the HTC, you know, four inch plus size phones that we've seen, like the Thunderbolt. Definitely much lighter than devices like that. So again, a bit of a balance there in terms of size and weight. Let's take a look around the phone. You've got your standard Android navigation buttons here. You've got the menu button, home, back, and search buttons. All of them illuminate when you touch them. Over here, you've got a power button, screen lock button. Up here, you've got a microphone and a headphone jack. Over here, you've got your volume rocker, pretty standard issue. And down the bottom, you've got your standard microphone and micro USB port. It's based on a 1.2 gigahertz Hummingbird processor. It's a single core Samsung Hummingbird processor. And it does have, again, a faster clock speed at 1.2 gig with updated graphics core. Also has 2 gig of internal storage ROM on board. Not quite what we would have liked to have seen. A little bit light in the storage capacity, but it does have a micro SD card slot that allows for expansion up to 32 gig. And let's see, 8 megapixel rear facing camera, 1.3 megapixel front facing camera. The rear facing camera does have a flash on board and shoots 720p HD video. So we should also note that back here is the speaker port for the phone right there. And the bezel and sides of the phone are built out of this strong but lightweight sort of composite material. It has a metallic looking finish to it. Really nice actually, and the phone does feel sturdy in the hand but remains light at about 4.9 ounces to be exact. And one of the ways they get to that lightweight is this lightweight backing. Not that thrilled, a little bit flimsy feeling here, but peels off easily, and then you get access to a very large battery and of course your SIM card right there and micro SD card slot. The phone is capable of 400 hours rated of standby time and about 8 hours rated talk time. And just to give you a quick sense of scale, here is the Infuse 4G in between the iPhone 3G and Dell's Mammoth Streak 5 tablet / smartphone. So significantly more real estate than the iPhone 3G for sure, but not as ridiculously large as the Streak 5 by any stretch. And as you can see, the Super AMOLED screen in between these two devices is, you know, the contrast, the brightness, the color reproduction, the blacks, all much better. And of course, the viewing angle capability of the device is significantly better as well. The Infuse is based on Android 2.2, otherwise known as Froyo, and you do get Samsung's light skin on top of the OS, which is actually really nice. Really large icons, very colorful, lots of contrast here. And as you can see, you get plenty of apps installed. You get your standard Samsung Media Hub, AT&T UVerse Mobile, UVerse Live TV, as well as Angry Birds is on here. But you can see there's lots of other applications as well. You've got your Navigator, you've got Gmail, you've got a Facebook app. Of course, contacts, calculator, all that good stuff. And they are grouped available on these customizable home screens that you can set up for your favorite apps for quick access. And then go ahead and swipe those home screens across and, you know, access the apps or the customized home screens that you wish on the fly very quickly. Browsing the web, things are pretty snappy. We're over an 802.11n wireless connection. We haven't gotten the ability to test the connection, 4G connection, AT&T 4G connection, but we're just now getting into testing this phone. And as you can see, we are accessing websites pretty snappy here. And pinch and zoom is of course available. Also very responsive. We're looking at hothardware.com. And we'll go ahead and install the flash there right on the fly. You can see we animated some of the ads that were waiting in flash for us. But go ahead and rotate here. And as you can see, orientation and portrait and landscape mode happens fairly quickly as well. Again, 1.2 gigahertz Samsung Hummingbird processor. So a very robust single core chip under the hood, perhaps not as fast a media processor or, you know, general purpose processor as say a dual 1 gigahertz Tegra 2 dual core, but again, a very robust processor, one of the faster processors on the market right now, the 1.2 gigahertz Hummingbird by Samsung. And here's a quick look at the Infuse 4G's camera application. Here again, 8 megapixel camera on board, really nice interface and controls, lots of settings for adjusting things like focus, brightness, flash, all that good stuff, contrast, you can do different effects. But you can also do pinch and zoom to use the zoom function. There's a 4x zoom, touch the screen to focus, and then snap a pic. So pretty good, really nice camera interface, and just a quick look at it. We'll have some results from the camera in the full review so you can take a look at the actual shots themselves. And as I mentioned earlier, the Infuse 4G has Samsung's new 1.2 gigahertz Hummingbird processor under the hood. And here we are playing the included Angry Birds game that comes with the phone. And as you can see, more than capable of handling this light duty game, not a heavy duty 3D game engine by any stretch with Angry Birds. But again, this is going to be a handset that's going to have a fair amount of multimedia and gaming capability built in with that fast Samsung Hummingbird processor. And finally, here we are running AN3D Bench, which is an Android-based graphics test suite that you can find on the Android marketplace. And the Infuse 4G, powered by the Samsung 1.2 gigahertz Samsung Hummingbird processor under the hood, here is going to score about 56.5 frames per second in the game level portion of this test, which is a good upper-end score for a high-end smartphone of this class. It's not the fastest score we've seen in the game level portion of this test, but again, a respectable score nonetheless. We'll have all the benchmark details, including tests across AT&T's 4G network at hothardware.com. Check out our full review in the days ahead. I'm Dave Altavilla with this quick take look at the Samsung Infuse 4G for AT&T. Thanks for stopping by.